More than a year since the pandemic wreaked havoc in the country, a lot of Filipinos continue to worry about catching the dreaded disease. A survey by the social weather stations from April 28 to May 2 shows 89% of Filipinos are worried of getting the virus. The number of Filipinos who think that the worst of the pandemic is yet to come also rose. From 31% in November last year, it's gone up to 49% in May. But who wouldn't be worried, especially with a rise in infections in various regions of the Philippines? The Southern Philippines Medical Center in Davao City, the country's largest public hospital, now has a filled intensive care unit with isolation wards 98% occupied. But the hope for improvement remains after Davao City was placed under modified enhanced community quarantine beginning June 5th.
You know, we have to balance the economy also, no, and the health. So I think with that days na nabigyan sa amin, baka I can see na mag-improve siguro, makontain namin yung virus.
A health official in Region 7 meanwhile defends the test upon arrival protocol for returning overseas Filipinos in Cebu, saying it actually has benefits.
If we conduct the testing upon arrival as contained in the EO of the governor, it only means, number one, we catch the cases very early on. So kapag ka-positive, kaagad na-quarantine natin siya. Pangalawa po, we save on cost.
President Duterte earlier instructed Health Secretary Francisco Duque to critique the province's protocol. And while the agency is set to hand its recommendation to Mr. Duterte, it emphasized that the recommendations are based on scientific evidence.
Atin pa rin pong binibigay na posisyon ng Department of Health, of course, is yun pong mga napagkasunduan sa IATF, which are all based on evidence and based on science. At ito po ang ating isinusulong na maipatupad sa lahat ng rehiyon sa ating bansa para po ma-break natin ang chain of transmission nitong COVID-19.
On Friday, the Philippine logged 7,450 new infections, the highest in the past week. It also logged the fewest recoveries at 2,382 since the DOH shifted to daily time-based tagging of recoveries. For the DOH, the continued worry over the raging pandemic should be seen as an opportunity.
We would like to shift this into a positive light. They perceived na ang COVID-19 is still a risk. We can take that opportunity para mas i-encourage silang magpabakuna.
For Dr. Edsel Salvana, COVID-19 will continue to be a concern until many Filipinos are vaccinated.
Whatever happens naman, kahit bakunado na po tayo ng COVID, ang COVID kasi constantly nag-mutate, pwede magkaroon ng bagong variants. It's not something that we will say na, okay, nabakunahan na ako, tapos na to para sa akin. It may be true for you in terms of decreased severity ng illness, hindi ka na mamamatay sa COVID, pero marami pa po sa ating mga kababayan ang hindi nababakunahan.
Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.